Hello, dear medicos. We are having the privilege to have Dr. Kunal Sharma with us, VMMC student, Delhi, getting rank 9, AIIMS, JIPMER rank 9, PGI rank 14, NEET is 118. So many great success.
Thank
we
you
congrats
so
you on the behalf of DAMS family.
Thank you so
So
much,
being
sir.
A VMMC student, personally, I congrats you. Okay, like from VMMC, you are going into the next side of the road, joining AIIMS. So
Thank
what
you
is
so much,
your
sir.
Experience with us? He was our pre-foundation. I want to stress on this point, being a pre-foundation student joining us from the second year, he gets such an awesome achievement. So let us share your experience with everybody.
So before I begin, I would like to be grateful to some people.
Yeah.
I want to thank my parents who have supported me throughout and backed all my decisions. I want to thank my friends who have believed in me whenever I have any doubts or even any phase that that's very low for me. And also the DAMS faculty and the DAMS support staff who have been guiding me from a very early period. And till the end, they have held their hand and I have been able to achieve this rank thanks to them.
Thanks being such modestly, you are giving all the success. Now sharing your strategy, like a pre-foundation batch, like you joined us in the second year, micro patho pharma segment. So how was your experience? You joined us, you were with us for the last 4 years. So how you plan each and everything?
Sir, I joined second year mainly to build my concepts, because these days the exam, the pattern exams, they are testing your concepts. They are not going, they are not checking your facts, they are not checking how much you are able to memorize. They are testing you on how much on the topics that are frequently encountered. And also I it was the first time that I came to know, that I came to experience what is the what is PG preparation, what is PG exams and the competition level for it. So that was the time I joined DAMS, and I had the very first class was micro by Dr. Partha Rakshit sir, and I'm thankful to him till this date, because he taught me how to go about reading in MBBS, how the importance of reading standard textbooks like Robbins, Anand Narayan. And from that that point onwards, the I got into the habit of reading standard textbooks. And also after reading standard textbooks, I used to correlate those with the notes, and so that I could build my concepts, strengthen my foundation. That
Here
is very
I
important.
Will, I will interrupt you. Just what I am interpreting from you, okay, you joined us in the second year. You are attending all the classes. These class notes are more than sufficient even for the prof examination. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
But even then, you go with the standard textbook. Yes, it sir. Means you didn't follow any shortcut. You go with this textbook, whatever the concepts were there, you just strengthen up those concepts. So first point which I want to share with every medico sitting across the country, can never follow any shortcut. Even you are having the DAMS class notes, being a second year student, he concentrate on the textbook. Why? To build up the strong basic concepts. How many MCQs, like if you say in the second year, I will be going step by step. In the second year, were you doing any MCQs, or you were only focusing on the textbook?
Sir,
and
I'll be honest, I tried doing MCQs, but I found that it was counterproductive, so I stopped doing MCQs. I didn't do any MCQs till the very last, till the internship.
Honestly, you are telling this point, second year you tried, but you can't. But you focus more on the.
Yes, sir. Because the pattern was also changing, sir.
Pattern was changing.
The new pattern of questions are coming up. So
as a second year student, we can say, okay, you should concentrate on the first and second. Now, if you enter from the second year to third year, you must appear for the prof examination. So what was the role of those class notes in the prof semester exam?
Sir, it was it helped me streamline and focus on, emphasize on what topics are important. It definitely helped me identify which, where I need to focus, where are my weaknesses, where I need to study for the prof examination, which topics I need to focus for the PG entrance examination as well. So along with that, my standard textbook knowledge, I used to go through them every time. And I think class notes, they were very focused, concise, and what they contained everything which you needed for the exams.
From the second year, you enter the third year as a foundation student. How was your experience in the third year, Vita?
Sir, in third year, we came across the final year subjects, medicine, surgery, and the core of PSM, ENT, Ophtha. Mm-hmm. And sir, since I had built my basic concepts, I had worked well on them. So it was easier for me to grasp the further subjects, the final year subjects, the short subjects, as well as the major subjects. I joined the foundation course.
So in the third year, you attend all the subjects with us.
Yes, sir. I made the notes. I used to read the notes. And along with that, if I had time, I for the major subjects like a PSM and OBS-GYN, I used to read the standard textbooks.
Standard textbook. We're coming on the short subject like radio, ortho, ENT. Mm-hmm. So you can rely on the class
notes. I can definitely rely on the class notes, sir.
On the class notes. So how was the experience in the prof examination? Like third year, when you appeared for ENT, BSM, Opthal, what was the role of the class notes of the third year in your prof examination?
Sir, if I talk about it individually, for ENT, the notes that you were taking our class, they were very, every concept was dealt with matlab great accuracy and in a very easy way to comprehend the topics and you could matlab at a later point of time I could revise those ENT notes in 1 to 2 hours. Absolutely. And those notes were not only helpful for the prof examinations, matlab I didn't have to rely on any books. Okay. For ENT
short subjects we can say we can. Yes. Rely purely on the class notes.
Purely on the
that
class
is a big
notes.
Help from, because you can get ample time for the major subjects. Yes. Where you can go on the standard textbooks.
And everything was covered, it was needed. So I was
comfortable in the third year. So it means third year. What was your strategy? Like I want to highlight this point, ke many students must be asking this point, ke in the third year, did you cover some part of the final year or you just focus on revising first and second year with BSM, ENT, Opthal?
Sir, in the third year, the major subject that I focused was on PSM.
Okay.
Apart and ENT, of course. Apart from that, I didn't give much attention to the basic preclinical first and second year subjects. Regarding the final year subjects, I used to go to clinical postings.
Okay.
I think I would also recommend everyone to be regular in clinical postings, because these days also, what you see, what you hear in clinical postings, that are also being tested. So I used to go to clinical postings. I also, and whatever was this being discussed there, I used to come back and read, especially for the final year subjects. I had started reading obs and gynae.
Okay.
And a little bit of pediatrics in the third year.
So what I am getting from you, from the second year onwards, you are making very nice class notes, and these class notes paid you nicely in your all central institute examination with all rank. So it means somewhere we are base should be the class notes on which we can rely for. Do you agree, like pattern is changing day by day, like AIIMS people, they have changed the pattern. So what do you feel, okay, even our teachers taught the concept 2-3 years back, those concepts were sufficient for new pattern? Because many students having this insecurity, okay, the pattern is changing day by day.
So I remember the day that AIIMS launched this new pattern. Mm-hmm. They released the news, so there were students who were panicking, but sir, I was comfortable because I knew the same old concepts, the same old topics that were being taught, which will be, they will be asked in a different way,
different
way, and the majority of the questions will be single basis response type. So there was no need to matlab take it as a
strong message for everybody. There is no need of getting pressure because of the new pattern. There is nothing new pattern, the concept will remain same, but yeah, way of asking MCQ will be different. Like in the internship, you are saying you have started doing MCQs, and what was the experience of our e-medicos online MCQ subject by grant test? If you compare with the level, with the AIIMS Central Institute, with our question bank, how you used to deal with those MCQs, how you apply the class notes?
Sir, e-medicos was helpful in supplementing extra knowledge. Mm-hmm. Getting extra some topics which are not covered in class, or some recent updates, some new drugs that were coming up. So that was covered. Also, I would like to emphasize on that Central Institute discussion, which helped me a lot to know what topics are being frequently asked. Then the DAMS test series app, I used to be very consistent, very regular with giving the grand test and the subject wise class test. And sir, it helped me gauge where I stand in the crowd, where I am doing my mistakes, what are my weaknesses, which weak subjects I should be spending more time on. And I was very regular in doing those MCQs.
So you compare with the level of the MCQs we are asking in the grand test subject wise. Now you appear for all the, I'm proud to say he got rank 9 in AIIMS, rank 9 in JIPMER, rank 14 in PGI. He cracked each and every exam with such an awesome success. So how you compare the level of the MCQs being asked in the grand test subject wise against the Central Institute exam?
The questions that were set in the grand test and the subject wise test were it was a little higher of higher level, but it was again the same. The concepts that were given in our notes, topics, it was an extrapolation of those concepts. It was, you need to apply it in a different way, but the concepts remained the same, and I found the questions were actually helpful in the end.
The level was on the higher side, but very, very helpful.
Yes.
That is what I interpret from you, we should better to go with the tough MCQs rather than going with the multiple easy going MCQs.
Yes.
What you say, you appeared for JIPMER, and I think everybody was giving the message that JIPMER MCQs were
Sir, JIPMER is an unpredictable exam.
Unpredictable,
sir.
Exam. I mean, so paper was tough, but with again with the gravity of the class notes, did you feel comfort in the all the MCQs of JIPMER?
What you feel? Along with the TND updates, TND's matter topics that were discussed along and the class notes, I think it was more than sufficient for the for the Central Institute. You have to put an extra effort,
extra
sir.
Effort.
So standard textbooks, TNDs, and the level of questions in the subject-wise test and the class test. That should be sufficient for the Central Institute.
Now, coming on to the Central Institute examination, like you appear for our, you are proud to say he's our pre-foundation student joining us in the second year. Your journey with us is for the last 4 years, you say pre-foundation, foundation, then you attend our TND. So, how is your experience? Okay, how the MCQs we are setting in the TND test and discussion, level of the MCQs against all the Central Institute exam?
Sir, the questions these days are again testing you on how much you know the concepts, not on any facts. And the questions, they also the questions that the faculty took so much effort in setting, they were new, they were very deep questions. Some of them were on topics which we need to emphasize on, need to spend more time on, and also the updates were also provided. And the faculty took very much effort in discussing that question, how to solve that question multiple ways. And that I found very nice about DAMS. And being regular with TND is very important. And how much you should come prepared to the TND, and even after the TND, you should be giving some time to analyze what your mistakes were and revise that subject again. Mm. That this is how you can gain more from the TND.
So you are adding all the updates you are getting in the TND in your class notes.
What and any new protocols or any new certain topic that we need to focus on for Central Institutes and all that.
Which topic, like you are coming on the update exclusive club, if DAMS exclusive club, what are the role of this exclusive club in your preparation?
Sir, DAMS exclusive club is been instrumental. It's a phenomenal site for asking doubts. And sir, you not only learn from other people's doubts, you can your queries and questions are immediately addressed by the faculty, and they provide us with reliable, authentic, and up-to-date answers. And so, and also there are certain series started by different faculties. For example, Dr. Rahul Rajiv sir, he used to discuss
medicine MCQs.
Yes,
yeah.
And and the ENT faculty also used to put the image-based some images and special topics. And I found and certain new MCQs or new topics which were coming
so
up.
So I'll be highlighting this word. You have used this authentic answers. This is very crucial in the current scenario when we are getting lots of feeding on the online. Okay, you should have been focused on the authentic answer rather than going with the wrong answer, because these questions matter a lot. Control. What are the important topics you feel for Central Institute examination? Like many students will be preparing for the upcoming AIIMS. So if I ask you, okay, you should focus on this segment. Which are the basic segment for Central Institutes?
So if I discuss for AIIMS, your first and second year subjects should be very strong. Preclinical sciences, they have been focused on that. And you have to build your concepts from the second or third year and read standard textbooks for that. If I had to recommend one standard textbook, please go through Robbins. There is no upper limit to how many times you can read it. There is always something new coming up in Robbins. And apart from that, class notes are sufficient. Dr. Diksha Sikri ma'am also used to provide infographics and a short, in a concise way, how to deal with any, tackle any a new topic or a specific topic. Also, there apart from preclinical sciences, obs gyne and PSM, the latest programs, epidemiology and biostatistics.
These are very important.
Yes, for AIIMS. For JIPMER, you cannot do much, but being thorough with the newer updates, especially pharmacology, and the newer advances in surgery, and being again up to date with the first and second year subjects.
Okay, that's good.
For PGIMER Chandigarh, sir, you need to practice mock tests, the multiple option is multiple response types, and you need to there are time constraints in PGIMER examination, so you need to solve questions faster and make sure that you are writing marking the wrong correct answers. Also, for PGIMER, new drugs, new advances, general surgery and GI surgery are important for PGIMER.
Yeah.
In AIIMS, breast and trauma in surgery are more important.
What do you think?
Also for PGIMER, they are more used to asking clinical sciences, medicine, surgery, obs-gyn-em. Obs-gyn-em and PSM are important in no matter what exam you sit. So that would be my first subject that I used to revise whenever I sat for it.
That's a great piece of advice to everybody. Now coming on, like, you appeared for our last two CBT with the rank 55 and 81. So how was your experience with our computer-based test?
So the first CBT was a little tough, but there were new questions as well. Because in exam, sir, you wouldn't have all the questions. That you will not be able to know all the questions. You need to extrapolate what knowledge you have. You need to draw conclusions from that and arrive at an answer. But so it helped me give a real simulation of the exam. It helped me. It also helped me anticipate that there will be questions, but you know,
like,
don't need
pattern. There will be tough questions.
There will be tough. There will be
of getting panic.
Also the image-based questions, and you don't need to be get emotional over questions. Every question has an equal weightage. If you don't know it, move on, append next question. You don't need to panic about this.
So all the images which we have covered in our CBT, we have covered in our DVT, as well as image we have given in our CBT's exam. So what do you feel, those images, the group of images, were sufficient for cracking all the Central Institute examination, or do you find difficulty in all the images given by AIIMS people?
Sir, DVT was outstanding. And I think apart from covering more than sufficient images for all of exams, it also helped me get a quick revision of all subjects, and it boosted my confidence, because at that point of time I hadn't even completed my first reading of the subjects, and I was feeling panicking what I will do, how I will perform in the exams, upcoming exams. But DVT was a confidence booster, and it most of the images they were sufficient to cover, and in AIIMS I think I got most of the image-based questions correct, and even in NEET, they were on the easier side, sir.
So NEET, like, maximum students are preparing for all in entrance exam, and you got 118, such a nice rank. So what was your strategy for NEET?
So for NEET, I was targeting the Central Institute from the beginning, and NEET, I just gave the exam. Okay. I knew I was.
So
I had
as
to
such
go.
No new separate strategy was there.
Be regular with the TNDs. Keep giving grand tests, as much grand tests as possible, because grand tests actually check the long term retention of your knowledge. They actually simulate the real exam and how much faster you can go. So you need to keep consistent with the grand test, no matter what is your level of preparation. I started giving grand tests in March, even though So my rank was used to come in 5 digits, but till November and December I used to get double digit ranks and single
digit
ranks.
What I'm getting from you, you should not stop giving these grand tests
definitely
in phobia
not.
Of getting less marks or less rank hardly matter.
The ranks, sir, you don't need to get emotional with the ranks. You be consistent and be regular, your progress will.
What I'm getting from your words, like class notes over the last 3 years with ample practice of MCQs, with these DVT images and multiple grand tests and all these MCQs are sufficient for getting all these good ranks in NEET and Central Institute examination.
Yes, sir.
Being a VMNC student, again, it is a big success that you are entering in the AIIMS with such a nice rank. And I hope for the last 2-3 years, you must have the dream of crossing the road and going to the AIIMS. And I still remember in my lecture, I used to this word for my VMNC student. So I just want a special message from you for your college.
I would recommend reading standard textbooks, and also the main thing is you need to dream. If you don't dream big, then you will not put an effort to get that thing. Have the passion, have the that burning desire to achieve that dream, and you will do it. You need to be persistent, don't give up. There will be phases of low and setbacks, but you need to struggle through, battle through them, and you will get what you want.
Thanks a lot for such a nice, awesome advice for everybody. And again, we congrats you for such a awesome achievement. None of the exam is there where he has not cracked the exam. That is a great success. And I feel that this will be a lifetime achievement for you. You have cracked all the exam, and now you're joining the next phase of your life. So very best of luck, best wishes from the Dams family. Thank you.